people take advantage of that.
All right, Chuck, good to talk with you. I appreciate your time today.
Xander. Xander.
Nomination, but Hillary Clinton's campaign insists she will not concede the race tonight. Pete Boykin is a Democratic strategist who served in the Clinton White House, and Andrea Chantaris is a Republican spokesman for the House Republican Conference. Keith, let's begin with you now. What possible reason would the Clinton campaign have, if he reaches that magic number, 2,118 tonight, for prolonging her decision, her announcement?
I think what Hillary Clinton wants to do is she wants to make a graceful exit if it's time for her to leave. I don't think she wants to look like she's being pushed out or forced out. She may end up doing relatively well in South Dakota tonight. She may want to take a moment to savor that victory if she perhaps gets a victory tonight. But even if she doesn't get that, I think what she wants is she wants to go on her own terms in her own time. So maybe she might wait a day or two.
But what better time than the end of the primary season? Montana, South Dakota, they wrap up their polls.
Well, one good reason why she might not do it tonight is because she doesn't get the attention. If tonight's story will be about Barack Obama clinching the nomination more than likely. Tomorrow, she will have an opportunity to have the news day to herself, so why do it today?
Andrea, what do you make of all of this? I think that it's all about leverage. Hillary Clinton drop out when she has leveraged what she needs. I mean, I'd like to believe the theory that, yes, it's all about news and attention, but the Clintons are a little more calculating than that, and she is in the driver's seat right now. That is the reality. She has a ton of delegates. She's got the bedrock of Democratic support, the rural voters, women voters, seniors. It's a lot of power. So now, she's thinking, what do? How do I leverage my power? She also has a lot of supporters who are angry. And they say, forget it. I'm not going to go to the polls in November and vote for Barack Obama. I'll either vote for John McCain, and I'll stay home. Is there room now at this point for the Republicans, Andrea Nottingham, to exploit that, to grow it into an even bigger segment of the population? Well, absolutely. I think it's like 1980 all over again. It was a highly